guys, and welcome to this video where towards the end of March, my brother and I decided to take a trip to Ireland to explore Ireland's wild Atlantic coast. We took a flight from London's Luton Airport to Ireland Shannon, then took a 2-hour bus from Shannon up to Galway. We started in Galway, which was a really youthful and vibrant city on Ireland's west coast, and then spent the day exploring the Aran Islands, mainly Inishmore, the biggest of the Aran Islands. We then spent our last day just exploring Galway and feeling the vibes there, so please let me know what you think and I hope you enjoy.
Welcome to Ireland. We'll be landing in 5 minutes.
This is quite a country, Brian. You know, Ireland has more drunks per capita than people.
Oh, that's a negative stereotype. I don't think the Irish drink as much as people say they do.
After our little excursion, we arrived in Galway. We checked into our hotel, which was right on Air Square, and immediately began exploring the city, going to a few pubs, the university, and then the cathedral. After that amazing sunset over Galway Cathedral, we headed out for dinner at Cava Bodega, a nice Spanish restaurant right in the heart of town. then went to go enjoy some of the famed live music that Galway is so well known for, starting with some traditional Irish music, or trad, as it's known by, then catching some modern music at the Keys Bar, both of which were really, really good. Second day in Galway, we woke up early to buy tickets for a ferry to the Aran Islands. But before we could get there, we had to take a 45-minute bus from the center of town to the ferry port in Rosavale. It was actually a really nice coastal drive along the way. Our plan once getting to the Aran Islands was to rent some bikes and explore as much as possible. And that's exactly what we did, cycling all the way to Dunangas, an ancient Celtic fort with breathtaking cliff views, and back, enjoying a bite to eat and a few drinks along the way.
Yeah. 16 years. 16 banners united over the field. Where the good shepherd grieves, desperate men, desperate women, divided, spreading their shadows to the marketplace. Merchants and thieves, hungry for power, my list still gone down. She's smelling sweet, like the meadows where she was born. On Midsummer's Eve, near the tower, the cold-blooded moon, the captain waits above the celebration, sending his thoughts to a beloved maid whose ebony face is beyond communication. The captain is down, but still believing that his love will be repaid. Her head, she was torn between Jupiter and Apollo. A messenger arrived with a black nightingale. I seen her on the stairs, and I could not help but follow her down. To my feet, I rode past destruction in the ditches with the stitches still mending neath the heart-shaped tattoo. Renegade priest and treacherous young witches were handing out the flowers that I give. Dark soldiers, I reflected the endless road, and the wailing of chimes, the empty rooms, where memory is protected, where the angels' voices whisper to the souls of previous times. She wakes him up. 40 hours later, the sun is breaking in broken chains. Mountain rolling, rolling rocks. She's begging to know what measures now he will be taking. He's pulling her down, and she's clutching onto his long golden locks. Gentlemen, he said, I don't need your organization. I've shined your shoes, I've moved your mountains, marked your cards, but Eden is burning. Either brace yourself for elimination, or else your hearts must have the courage for the changing of.
Surrenders with its pale ghost retreating between the
After an amazing day on the Aran Islands, really the highlight of the trip, we headed back to Galway and spent the evening relaxing with a few beers and enjoying some more of that famed live music. For our last day in Galway, we explored the rest of the city sites, including Lynch's Castle, the Spanish Arch, and the Cladda, a really idyllic and relaxing area in the city where the River Corrib meets the shore, all well worth seeing. After an amazing first trip to Ireland's west coast, it was time to head back to London, and overall, I would say that Galway and the Aran Islands were both totally worth visiting, and probably don't get the recognition they deserve, but I'm already looking forward to going back someday soon. remember, guys, if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.
Cheers, guys.
Hey! Oh, we got it.